Good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Arafath Husna, and this is my co-presentator, Nagma. We are from Dr. VRK Women's Medical College. We are here to present you all an interesting and a rare presentation of pregnancy in a cesarean scar. Case history. Mrs. S, 27 years old, G3P2L2, was referred to our hospital for evaluation and management of quiriectopic pregnancy from a private hospital. The patient was apparently asymptomatic 6 weeks back and had noticed spotting per vaginum on and off for a week with a history of 6 weeks amenorrhea. Her obstetric history shows first lower segment cesarean section delivery of an alive male baby who's 6 years old and second lower segment cesarean section delivery of an alive female baby 3 years old. Present pregnancy is a quiriectopic pregnancy. Her last menstrual period was on 20th of May 2013 and her expected delivery date was on 27th February 2014. On examination, the vitals of the patient were normal. Her blood pressure 110 by 70 mmHg, pulse rate 83 per minute. But abdominal examination was normal, and on examining, performing the pervaginal examination, the findings were bulky uterus with slight tenderness in all the fornices. Now, the management. Evaluation. Her urine pregnancy test was positive, which was followed by ultrasound scanning. This was done in order to confirm the pregnancy, and on performing the ultrasound scanning, the gestational sac was found to be located on the previous cesarean scar, and the problem was diagnosed as the ectopic pregnancy in the previous surgical scar. In this picture, we can see here is the gestation sac, and this is the colors dopplers, and this is the rough diagram showing the location of the gestation sac located just behind the scar, previous scar. Plan of management, operative exploration. Preoperatively, surgical profile was done, reserving blood. Laparotomy. The patient was posted to surgery the next day, and the findings were the anterior wall of the uterus was attached to the anterior abdominal wall by adhesions, which was removed by sharp dissection. The uterovesicular fold of the peritoneum was open and the bladder was pushed down. A small bulge was noted in the previous cesarean scar. Then 1 cm transverse incision was made with a cautery over the bulge, following which the sac with contents bulged out. The products of conception were removed and sent for histopathological examination. Then the uterine cavity was digitally evacuated of all the products of conception until there was nothing left. And then the uterine incision was closed in 2 layers. Hemostasis was secured. Then it was followed by tubectomy. Both the fallopian tubes were next ligated by modified Pomeroy's technique, and then the abdomen was closed in layers. The condition of the patient after the surgery was stable. Here in this picture, we can see the incision being given to the gestation sac using a cautery. In this picture, we can see the contents being removed, the contents of gestation sac being removed with the help of an artery forceps. These are the contents of the gestation sac which were sent for histopathological examination. Post-operative recovery of the patient was uneventful, and then the patient was discharged with an advice to come for follow-up on the 5th post-operative day. Review of literature. Incidence of ectopic pregnancies in general. Nowadays, in every 40 to 25 pregnancies, at least one of the pregnancies is being an ectopic pregnancy. The most frequent locations are 90 to 95% of the cases are found in fallopian tubes. The less frequent locations are 2% of the cases in the interstitium of the tube, 1 to 2% of the cases in abdominal cavity, 1% in the ovary, 1% in the accessory horn in the biconoid uterus and cervical. Last but not the least, the cesarean scar being the most rarest of all, 0.05%. Implantation of the pregnancy within the scar of a previous cesarean delivery is the rarest of the ectopic pregnancies. Only 19 cases have been reported in the English medical literature since 1996 up till the year 2001, and the first case was brought to light in the year 1978. Scar implantation is a gestation which is completely surrounded by the myometrium and the fibrous tissue of the scar and separated from the endometrial cavity, unlike the normal gestation sac which is present within the endometrial cavity. The predisposing factors, previous pelvic inflammatory diseases, pelvic tuberculosis, intrauterine contraceptive devices, progestogen-only pill users, previous tubal surgery, in vitro fertilization, gamete intrafallopian transfer technique, and previous ectopic pregnancies. spontaneous miscarriage, and these conditions have to be differentially diagnosed. Ectopic scar pregnancy have to be differentially diagnosed from the following conditions, like spontaneous miscarriage in progress, trophoblastic tumor, cervicoisthmic pregnancy, lowly implanted intrauterine pregnancy. The complications are, it should be diagnosed as early as possible as it carries high risk of myometrial rupture with fatal outcome. It's more life-threatening than placenta previa and accreta because of early myometrial invasion in the first trimester itself, and surgical interventions may compromise with the future fertility. And take-home message, early ultrasound scan done reveals pregnancy at ectopic locations, and to improve the future fertility is necessary to make a diagnosis as early as possible, even before the ectopic sac ruptures, and this is possible only with a routine ultrasonic scanning in the early pregnancy itself. Early diagnosis is the key to the conservative management. Thank you. And we would like to thank our Dean, Dr. A.Y. Chari, for guiding us in presenting this case, and Dr. Aruna Rachel, Professor in HOD of Gynecology. Cervical pregnancy, cervical ectopic pregnancies, and then cervical carcinoma of cervix. In which pregnancies? Cervicoisthmic pregnancies. Cervicoisthmic pregnancies and
previous cesarean sections, most probably. Not all, but very rarely. But most multiple probably, it is sections. Multiple cesarean sections. Ma'am.
Delayed implantation also, delayed implantation of the gestation, delayed implantation of the embryo.
IVF.
And progestogen only pills also may lead to. Delayed movements of the fallopian tubes, ma'am. Even that may be one of the reasons. So that may delay delay in the implantation of the embryo. Because on performing DNC, there is a chances of perforation. So. No, ma'am. We have taken a consent, ma'am. We have taken a. We'll first ask if whether she's. There are chances of future infertility, ma'am. No, hysterectomy. In the further, in if she's pregnant for the next time, then there are high chances of rupture. We have taken her consent, ma'am, for both hysterectomy as well as tubectomy. The myometrium, the thickness of the myometrium varies in these two conditions. In case of cervicoisthmic pregnancy, myometrium is normal, whereas in case of cesarean scar pregnancies, the myometrium is thin, less than 5 millimeter.
Empty uterine cavity, empty cervical canal, and myometrium is defective where the distal sac is present.
Milking of fallopian tubes.
No, not tubectomy. For this case, you have done tubectomy.
Yes.
If you don't do tubectomy and labor, that is one thing. At the during the surgery, intraoperative complication.
Intraoperative.
And if you have left without doing tubectomy, what are the complications?
What?
Next pregnancy may also be an ectopic pregnancy, scar ectopic pregnancy, and during the operative procedure, the trophoblastic cells may leading to hemorrhage. Repeated cesarean sections or ectopic pregnancy. The patient may get an ectopic pregnancy at any location, which is highly prone for hemorrhages, and hemorrhage may lead to shock and with a fatal outcome. Rupture of the uterus. Life threat.
wasn't accurate.
Has to be done, then tell them that this is a complication can happen, so they should undergo sterilization along with second pregnancy once she delivers. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.